Hey, Merry Christmas. This is probably my last
repair for the year, I think.
Gonna have to take a little break.
Skater McGee came and got his Stratocaster, but he brought me his really cool bass, which has got a little bit of a gulch here at the end. He's got a little bit of a fret buzz here. Oh, we're hating that. So, it's actually this one that's the culprit. So we gotta take some away from that. And that's what we're gonna do, hold on. So I'm gonna loosen off the strings and get them out of the way. And I did check to make sure the neck's straight. But the only way to, there, good shot of my elbow, perfect. The only way to really make sure I take enough off is I have to put string tension back on, because that's critical.
Okay.
Here we go, hold on. My eggnog's getting low, but we'll fix that up in a minute too. So you can really, woohoo! See the old rocker rock on top of that high spot. So this is just a piece of a regular old mill file with all the sides ground off so you don't do anything stupid. And I'm going to take a little bit off top of the fret till it levels out with the other two beside it. There was this guy on Expert Village that was just, I couldn't believe it. I'll try and find the link, but he was like saying you had to grind material off the two frets beside the one that was high, and he was beating on it with a tool, and it was just pathetic. I gotta find that link. It had to be a comedy. It was like me being really nasty, worse than I can be. If you put your camera on the guitar to film, don't put it on the pickups. Something to do with the magnetic hard drive and magnets in the pickups. So we're just going to take a little bit off. You see, if you're careful, you don't have to get into all that masking tape and taping things off and all that nonsense. Let's see what happened. I'll get the rocker thing back out. So that's about it, just a little bit of dust. So now before I recrown the fret and polish it, put the strings back in the slots, tune it to pitch, and make sure we got rid of the buzz. That's sort of where the problem was, right here. We solved it, but now I got to put the crown back on the fret and polish it and get the hell out of here. I always use the magnifying glass to match the crowning file to the fret. I don't eyeball that because you can easily get the wrong file in your hands. Okay, shiner up. The diamond guys here are fantastic because they work in both directions. And then we have a look with the magnifier. These guys go up to 300, which is good. Not shiny enough. I'll show you in a minute. I will finish it off with some sandpaper. So that's the amount of material that the crowning file has taken off. So you saw, it's virtually nothing. It's dust. To get it right, that's what was in the way. So now I'll clean up all the other frets so they're shiny like the one I worked on. And we'll oil the fretboard for Skeeter McGee. Put the strings back on it. She's good to go, buddy. I don't know. I know I told you
next week, but maybe if you're around and you want to grab it, I'm kicking around until probably Christmas Eve. Cheers! That's the kind of goo that builds up on your frets, and I'm sorry, steel wool won't get that off. What I'm doing is I'm using the linseed oil as a lubricant, and I'm using 2,500 grit sandpaper, wet dry sandpaper. Check that out, huh? What a difference. Cool. Cool. Oh, hey, and thanks for the bottle of wine. That's great. I really appreciate it. Thank your mom for that. And show her the videos. She'll get a kick out of it.